resilience of Bordeaux is quite amazing when you realize that this place has been able to survive revolutions, wars.
Things can change in both directions. What we must protect is the wine.
The film focuses on a landmark year in French winemaking history. After two consecutive years of outstanding vintage, coincided with economic meltdown in Europe.
The major chateaus immediately raised the prices of the 2010 vintage to an all-time high, as much as 40% up on the record 2009 vintage.
Traditional markets such as the US and UK found the price hike hard to swallow, leaving the door open for a new player with a thirst for the red stuff.
China, including Hong Kong, has now become the largest importer of Bordeaux wines in the world.
They just erupted, and we were afraid of not being able to cope with such a fast change. I mean, we didn't know the country, and we didn't know the people, the culture.
We were told that at the current rate of the rate of uptake of the Chinese drinking wine, that in 20 years or thereabouts, the entire world's production wouldn't be enough to satisfy just the Chinese market. That was an astounding fact for us. So we dug a little bit deeper and found that the Chinese government, sort of one step ahead or two steps ahead, had decided that the Chinese should be planting vineyards, and they are now planting at the rate of something like 30,000 acres every year.
Right now, I think everyone has the wine fever.
You have seen demand massively exceed supply.
This is a film about wine, and it's about elite wine. It's a film about, you know, the most expensive wine on the planet. But it's really deeper than that. It's really about this shift in economic power from the West to the East. And how do two cultures come to understand each other? You know, how do two cultures begin to trade with each other?
The auctioneer was going like 300,000, 500,000. Then suddenly I just raised my power. It's at 1.5 million.
In 2011, the wine bubble burst and prices collapsed. Since then, Chinese demand has continued to increase, but at a slower rate. But wine experts are predicting the direction of the fine wine market will continue to flow from west to east. Neil Curry, CNN.